Well, good day out there, and thank you for joining me on this fine Friday. We're here to kick off the weekend right with a quick review of some of the exciting events, milestones, and happenings that Aero residents have enjoyed this past week. Yes, it's Friday, July 21st, 2023. My name is Lenny Hernandez, and we have a great show in store for you today. So take a deep breath. Because here we go. We're going to be seeing how Sandia Vitalia Montrose was honored by the Akron Zoo and featured on the news. A resident at Boulevard Winsville publishes a book of her late husband's poems. Nicely News host and Aero Managing Director of Marketing Nicole Rosa earns a prestigious honor. Is it prestigious or prestigious? Tomato, tomato. It's awesome. Vitalia Westlake holds a resident art show. Communities everywhere celebrate Don't Step on a Bee Day. And finally, we wish a Princeton resident a very happy birthday. Jeez Louise, we got a full plate of delicious stories to get to, so let's not waste any more time and let's dig in. Welcome to Aero Nicely News. Well, our first story of the day is about Sandy Delaria. Sandy is a resident of Vitalia Montrose and a patient of Suncrest Hospice who spent 22 years volunteering at the Akron Zoo, where she even has her name on a placard outside the lion's den. She recently returned for a special visit, which was also covered by local Fox 8 News. So for more on this story, I sat down with Austin Marsh, Resident Services Director of Vitalia Montrose.
Sandy is a resident here in our assisted living. And in conversation with her hospice company, Suncrest Hospice, we found out that Sandy used to be an Akron Zoo volunteer, which was super inspiring. So in hearing about the impact that she had at the zoo, we figured why not give her an opportunity to go and visit the individuals she used to work with and see the animals that she helped raise. So in collaboration with Suncrest Hospice, we jam-packed our bus and took 13 total residents to the Akron Zoo. It was a lot of fun. And we all piled in the bus and we went down to the Akron Zoo, where we were greeted by, 10 to 15 individuals, including the CEO, the director of education, and all sorts of high-ranking executives of the Akron Zoo. And then they took us on a behind-the-scenes VIP journey. They created all sorts of awesome experiences for us. So we started with the penguins when they enjoyed their breakfast and they were, you know, jumping and diving in the water and doing their thing. They drizzled honey on the inside of the viewing windows of the grizzly bears that Sandy actually helped raise from birth. We went behind the scenes with the lions and were actually able to see a staff-only viewing area of the lions, which, I mean, even for me is a once-in-a-lifetime experience. So it was absolutely amazing. We ended our day with a donated lunch by the Akron Zoo. And during lunch, we had a little bit of a ceremony that was done by the Akron Zoo. They honored Sandy with a gift, a big homemade card with a bunch of signatures and some origami flowers on it that one of the other volunteers, I do believe daughters, made. And then one huge event Sandy used to help out with was the Snow Bowl, which I do believe is a fundraiser for the Akron Zoo. So they took a considerable amount of t-shirts and actually made them into a quilt for Sandy that she now has in her apartment.
I heard that some people signed up to be a volunteer moving forward. Is that correct information?
Yes. So our floor nurse, Amy, that I mentioned, and I have actually applied to be volunteers at the Akron Zoo, and later in the month we'll be attending our orientation. We have been accepted as volunteers. So when we're not here in the community, we'll be volunteering at the Akron Zoo.
What an incredibly inspiring story. Austin, thank you so much.
All right. Thanks, Lenny.
Thank you so much for sitting down with me, Austin, and a huge congratulations to you and to Sandy for all of your amazing volunteer work at the Akron Zoo. Next up, we pop on over to the Boulevard Senior Living, Winsville, where resident Carol Bales has completed a five-year endeavor to publish a collection of her husband's poems. Her husband, Donald Mahoney, grew up in Chicago and was a champion Irish dancer in his youth. He found a passion for poetry and was published in many different journals, magazines, and newspapers. The book is titled In Break Formation and Other Poems and is the first print collection of Donald's work. The poems are beautiful. They're full of joy, pain, and wonder, and express his heart in a way that will move you. You can find In Break Formation and Other Poems by using this QR code or following the link in the description. So a huge congratulations, Carol, on your achievement and on honoring Donald. Next, we have an amazing announcement to make about Arrow Nicely News' very own Nicole Rosa. She has appeared on the show, of course, intermittently over the years, and last week she knocked it out of the park hosting our episode about VITALIA Manor. We are huge fans of our friend Nicole, and so we are thrilled to announce that she has been honored by Aging Media Network as a future leader for 2023. This means that she has displayed the most promising talent for someone 40 or under in the field of senior housing. As George Yednak, Executive Vice President of Healthcare and co-founder of Aging Media states, the members of the Future Leaders Class of 2023 have demonstrated an exceptional commitment to enhancing the lives of seniors, families, and staff. Individually, they have displayed a remarkable dedication to transcending their everyday responsibilities and embracing a forward-thinking approach towards the future of aging. Now, if that doesn't describe Nicole to a T, then I don't know what does. Although, to add to it, Nicole is an incredibly kind-hearted, generous, driven, intelligent, and talented person. Everyone here at Nicely News and at Arrow are proud to be her teammates and are proud of her accomplishments. Use this QR code right here or follow the link in the description to learn more. And a huge congratulations to you, Nicole. Congratulations, congratulations. Yeah. Yeah. Future stars of 2023, yo! VITALIA Westlake recently celebrated the creativity of the residents by hosting their first ever art show happy hour. The community is filled with talented artists who were excited to show off their stunning works. So many different styles and mediums were on display, including watercolors, charcoal, photography, oils and pastels, needlework, and so much more. Residents enjoyed some wonderful wine and delicious charcuterie as a jazz pianist set the mood for the event. The community was practically overflowing with beautiful works, and every way you looked, you were greeted by another spectacular piece for your eyes to enjoy. It was a veritable cornucopia of incredible art, and you should be able to pop on over to VITALIA Westlake social media to see all the rest, because there is just too much to fit into this one story here. So congratulations to all the amazing artists at VITALIA Westlake as you all put on one heck of a show, that's for sure. Well, and that brings us to Don't Step on a Bee Day. Don't Step on a Bee Day is a holiday that is mostly observed in the United Kingdom, but has been gaining popularity here in the States, and of course is beloved by Arrow Senior Living as well. The day is meant to honor the integral role that bees have in our ecosystem and lives. Without bees, many plants can't pollinate, creating a domino effect that can devastate animal life and lead to ecosystem collapse, which of course is an all-around very, very bad deal for everyone. So this day is a day to celebrate bees, remove the fear of our little black and yellow friends, and learn how we can help protect them and thus help protect ourselves. Communities spent the day celebrating with mouth-watering honey-themed food, drink, and desserts. They also decked the scenery in delightful bee and honey-themed decorations and settings. There were bee-themed parties and games, as well as viewings of Arrow's Don't Step on a Bee Day diversity and inclusion video, featuring artist, community scientist, conservation photographer, TEDx speaker, and founder of BeeSip, Crystal Hickman. The day was a joyous celebration of our tiny friends, the bees, and residents all over Arrow absolutely loved the day. And for all of you out there, be sure to do your part to take care of bees, even if it's something as small as not stepping on one. Don't step on a bee day! And now, as we bring our show to a close, we'd like to send a very happy birthday to Kay at the Princeton Senior Living. Kay is celebrating 102 trips around the sun. That is triple digits, folks. We hope that you had the happiest of birthdays, Kay. Well, everybody, that'll do it for this episode of Arrow Nicely News. We hope that it lifts your spirits as you start the weekend off, and that you won't, of course, miss us too much while we are apart. Don't you dare miss us. Don't you dare. For Aero Nicely News, I'm Lenny Hernandez. Have a wonderful weekend, an even better week, and we will see you all next Friday.